What's up, guys? Welcome back to my channel. And today I'm going to be talking about Resident Evil Infinite Darkness. This is a Netflix anime series. And I've been a Resident Evil fan since my friend put me on to the first Resident Evil for the PlayStation. And I've just been a fan ever since. And for some reason, I just couldn't wait for a CGI movie of Resident Evil to be released, because these movies here, they were given to me by my uncle. The live action ones, like Resident Evil Retribution, I truly wasn't a fan of the live action ones. This one here is Sealed Afterlife. So I wasn't really a fan of it at all. And just the fact that he had given it to me, so it just, you know, it made me really think. Like, I mean, the only good thing is that they had Nemesis from Resident Evil 3 in one of those live action movies. I don't remember which one it was, but I was with one of my friends where we went to the theater to see it. And I just remember being disappointed because it wasn't the characters that we, you know, grew up with and loved. Like, you know, like you got Leon, you have Claire, of course, until finally 2008, they ended up releasing Resident Evil Degeneration. And yes, I got this on DVD back then. And then they came out with Resident Evil Damnation. And I was like already just hyped up. And I was like, to me, this is the real Resident Evil. And then I have here Resident Evil Vendetta. And these CGI versions of the movies are the real Resident Evil to me. And right here I have the Blu-ray version of all three of them. I had to get it because, again, I'm upscaling a lot of these movies to Blu-ray. So again, to me, the live-action Resident Evil movies weren't really all that to me. Like I said, I think I've only seen one of them, and that's the one with Nemesis. I can't even tell you which one is which, because I really didn't care for it, and I felt like it truly wasn't a Resident Evil. But the CGI anime versions, they do follow the games a lot much more better than the live action ones. So let's check out the trailer here for Resident Evil Infinite Darkness. That looks painful.
He's still alive. You want to talk about it?
Every night I have the same nightmare. That day, that was hell.
I remember people screaming.
What's going on?
Oh, lights out.
They get bit and then they turn.
Yo, tell me how that dude looked like, a zombie looked like the Joker.
And spread.
That was hilarious.
Terrifying.
Leon? It's gotta be another outbreak.
I gotta go. Don't do anything stupid.
Raccoon City was the beginning. We can't let what happened stay buried. But if we went public with this, we could expose a conspiracy. I can't get anyone to go on record about the outbreak.
Sorry, I don't know what to tell you.
We need to show the world that we are a strong nation, capable of protecting the interests of the free world.
We must be the source of hope to those who seek freedom. We cannot allow anyone to interfere with peace and prosperity.
What are you here for?
That's classified. You know where the root of terror comes from? It starts with fear.
Okay.
I will show you fear.
Oh, that dude looks sick. So after watching the trailer, I gotta say that creature towards the end of the trailer looked really awesome. that looks like it's going to be something serious. So this Resident Evil Infinite Darkness, from what I read up on, is supposed to follow as a sequel to Resident Evil 4 from the game. I don't know if it's going to have anything to do with like Damnation or Degeneration or Vendetta, but hopefully it'll break some stories into how it's supposed to be. So this comes out on July 8th, and that's when people can stream it. 7 days from now, I'm counting down the days. Again, I would rather have this than to have a live-action Resident Evil movie. Like I said, those, that Retribution thing and the other one, Afterlife, I didn't really check those out. I can't remember where Nemesis was in, and frankly, I really don't care for that. It just really wasn't Resident Evil to me. But this, like I said, this is supposed to be like a mini series, and I can't wait for this. So once again, I'm hyped for this because I've been a true Resident Evil fan since I played the first Resident Evil in 1996. And I believe in one of the Resident Evil movies, in Damnation, they actually show like a flashback, and it shows the Resident Evil 2 cutscene of when Leon and Claire are running. And that's just an incredible thing that they did, because it actually gave fans what we truly wanted to see. So again, I'm hyped for this series, and I'll catch you guys in the next video. Don't forget to like, smash that like button, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Thanks for watching.